So, Mr. Welcome to this discussion.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Basil.
We talking to a very, you know, distinguished organization representative, and I'm sure your knowledge about these matters are very extensive.
Thank you.
So could you just give us some introduction to some of the major problems faced with dealing with arrest, detention, and things like that?
Yeah, we have the force in the norm of order in the law. We have the problem with the law, with the KUHAP, apa ya, criminal procedure law. Yeah. It's so long since 1981. So the problem is the rule, the article in the in this law is not comply with ICCPR, not comply with the newest regulation in human rights in Indonesia, because Indonesia has amendment the basic law, the constitutional law in 1999 until 2002, and adopt a lot of human rights article in the constitutional, but the criminal procedure law doesn't reformation until now. So it's the first. The second one, the biggest problem in Indonesia is the police. It's about the culture, because the police in Indonesia before reformation is one body with the military. So the culture in the police of in Indonesia is a military culture. Yeah, the second one is the biggest problem is about the police culture, because the police culture is so long after before reformation is joined, is one body with the military. So the police is militarist, have the culture of militarism. Apa ya, istilahnya mengedepankan kekerasan, apa ya, Chris?
Tend to use violence approach.
Yes. Tend to use violent approach, using torture as method. Then not professional police, not civilian police in Suharto era. So after reformation era, post Suharto era, the police with the military divided different institution. Police is make in one independence organization, and the other army, navy, and also the air force, different organization. But until now, police still adopt militarism way in education, in using the method of investigation like that. So in our research, we found 80% process in Jabodetabek, Jakarta, Bogor, and in capital area, we found the 80% suspect tortured by police, even tortured by physic or physically, or maybe sexual torture. And the second one is in the police staff, the culture. The third one is about the also in the public culture. Public culture in Indonesia, it's like if we find the violation, it's not the public is only complain, but not to be a big complain. If you found the police violation in US or in Yunani like that, in the Greek, is the to be a riot. For example, in Black Lives Matters, it's about the police brutality. But in Indonesia, the public which is to speak up is only activists, not public as a public like academician or maybe parliamentary member or maybe a researcher like that. Only NGO to speak up about the police violation like that. So it's the problem in norm, in the police brutality, in the the plus also impunity. For example, in the last year in 2019, when the 100 student and also university student ditangkap ya istilahnya ya. Apa Chris tangkap?
Arrest.
100 student arrest by police and rarely all students tortured by police. And we came to the top management in the police in Jakarta and we are complain to the general Gatot, now
Vice Commander of the Indonesian Police Commander.
Yeah, Vice Commander, and he said, we can do anything. ini dianggap sebagai sebuah kenormalan, is apa ya?
This kind of situation is, you know, the police point of view, it is kind of normal situation, Mr.
Yeah.
Basil.
Yeah, because the police facing the situation heavy when maybe police assume in the backing of student they are maybe army like that. So the police use it is about it is not. Not individual, kesalahan individu, tapi ini kesalahan sistematis gitu.
So this is not the individual who create this problem, but this is the problem create by problematic system, ya.
Yes, komando, this is komando. So it's just structure. By common and massive situation, not only in Jakarta, the brutality police happen also in North Sumatra, in West Java, in East Java, in Eastern Indonesia, in Makassar, Kendari, Papua. So it's also relating to the body, to the police institution. Not only the individual, or we call it oknum.
So is the this kind of brutality used on demonstrators, or is it also used against the suspect on other crimes?
In also used in other crime, actually in also in maybe we call it in kejahatan keras, relating to the apa ya, pencurian dengan kekerasan, kejahatan jalanan, itu polisi pasti akan sangat keras.
So it's, you know, Mr. Basil, like ordinary crimes, like a thief, and crimes which occurred on the street, the police also use the violence and also torture approach to dealing with the case.
In our cases, in the first, for example, in my cases in 2010, one children, 14 years age, suspect for tip, and the police torture. Can you imagine 14 years, without a lawyer accompanying him, without the parent, without the social social worker accompanying him. So it's like it's like a culture in Polis.
You know, now in your legal aid organization's capacity, you would have come across many cases like that.
Yes. Yes.
So,
from Aceh to Papua.
See, other than Papua, you know, which is more of a
even this harmful violation happened to our lawyer. For example, Tommy and Haris Barka, they are depend the victim. They are depend the victim in the police office, and the police doing kekerasan to our lawyer.
Could you explain those two cases a little bit more in detail? The assault on lawyers.
Yeah, for example.
Details. Where and when and how it happened.
Yeah, we have two cases. The first case is Tommy and Haris Barka. He is our lawyer in our Jakarta branch office. One day, she's she's accompanying the suspect and also the witnesses in the Jakarta, North Jakarta police office. So when the time it's maybe 11 p.m. in the night, and Tommy and Haris asked to the police because this witness is children, a woman, and tomorrow has to going to school. And Tommy and Haris asked the police to permit go out from the police office, and the police melarang.
Prohibit
the Tommy and Haris for leaving the police office. So the Tommy and Haris leave the police office without the permit from police. And after that, the police memukuli Tommy dan Haris.
Beating the lawyers, yeah.
Beating the lawyer.
Were they injured?
Terluka nggak?
Injuries? Yeah, terluka. For one night in.
Yes, they got injured, Mr. Basil.
Minimum injured. Not bloody like that. What?
When did this happen?
Kapan?
2009 or 2010, maybe, for example.
So did the bar association and people took that case up?
Yeah. The National Police Commission, yeah. Also the community and our colleague from the National Bar Association, it's a protest to the police. And that in this office, we found also the other cases when the one lawyer, arrested for 14 days.
Arrest and detained for 14 days, yeah?
14 days, in another case. In same police office in North Jakarta. Because they are, defend his client.
What is the, normally the situation of lawyers with the
not normally, but it's happened. The second one in 2015, when 1,000 labor have a demonstration in front of a presidential palace in Jakarta, when the situation maybe at 6 p.m. police asked to the labor to leave the tempat aksi.
Presidential palace, no?
Yeah, police asked the labor to leave the front of President Palace because it's in the night, and police prohibit the labor to all and also the demonstration to make a demonstration in the night, and police doing a tear gas and also water cannon, give tear gas and water cannon to the mass, and also our two lawyer arrest by police and dituntut di muka sidang karena
So the two lawyers of Indonesian Legal Aid also arrest and prosecute before the court.
Yeah, with the also together with 21 labor. Suspecting with charge with istilahnya melawan polisi, melawan perintah petugas.
Tidaklah
karena melawan perintah petugas untuk membubarkan diri.
Charge against the police.
Instruction.
Criminally charge, yeah. Disobedience against the police.
Yeah. If your organization is asked, what are the changes you want in the criminal procedure in order to protect the victims as well as protect the lawyers?
Yeah. Since 2000, our organization and also Chris from Contrast, from ELSAM, another NGO, was trying and also speak up to the parliament, to the government, to the also Ministry of Human Rights to renew, to reformation the criminal procedure law. And also we are have a lot of briefing paper. We have a lot of FGD with the government, with the president, member of parliament, to renew this criminal law procedure. But the government is not like it's not priority law to reformation. The government make a criminal code as a priority because we don't have criminal code since the 1945 in Indonesia Independence Day. We are using the legacy from Netherlands, legacy from the...
So what happened? 45 is the Dutch law?
Yeah, because Indonesia is colonized by Dutch.
I know that.
So after Independence Day in 1945, Indonesia used the legacy from the Dutch law, criminal code.
Yeah.
Until now.
During the Suharto's time, it was not changed?
No, until now.
I see.
Until now, we are using the criminal code from Dutch.
Okay. Now, if you can summarize, what are the main things that you want change in the criminal procedure?
We suggest to comply with the ICCPR. Force action from police in the penangkapan istilahnya Chris?
In the arrest, pre-trial detention.
Yeah, in the arrest, in the pre-trial detention is too long and too big mandatory to police doing anything. Police can detent in the pre-trial detention 90 day. Today the first and second 40 day in the process, and then 30 day. So the police can arrest, detain the suspect for 90 days, and also the prosecutor can arrest also before the before trial also 80 days. So it's so long, and the process is not objective. It's only
What have you, your organization? How does it want it to be changed?
Yeah, we doing a draft. Apa istilahnya? Draft article. We support the Ministerial of Human Rights and Law to and assist them to make a bill, and almost the draft is done almost, and the Ministerial of Law and Human Rights, the prosecutor, Mahkamah Agung,
the Supreme Court,
it's almost apa setuju.
Almost agree or accept
this draft, this bill draft, but only police reject this draft, bill draft. So in 2012, actually 2012, it's almost bring President SBY to parliament, and when the police reject this draft of bill, the SBY hold this draft of bill. Actually, it's more better than before.
So you have the draft from 2012.
Yeah, the last draft in 2012. So since 2012, the process is hold until now. So when Jokowi era, our president now since 2015, the Jokowis don't have any attention to the human rights in his speech, presidential speech. Not one word. He speak about human rights. He only speak about infestation. It's the problem now, because the oligarch in Indonesia, in the top gear to run. Now in Indonesia we facing the omnibus law. Change the 79 law in one way, in one law. So we will facing the big potential for human rights violation in the future, because this law open infestation is very very liberate, very very liberal. So the farmer, the custom people, customary people, so will in the future will facing more big problem also with the police. So it's the political problem when the party in Indonesian party don't have any progressive idea. They are rarely, maybe the background is pengusaha.
The entrepreneur.
Yeah. Maybe investor or entrepreneur. So they are drafting of bill in parliament member only thinking about the infestation.
So from 2012, Did any political parties support these changes to the Criminal Procedure Code?
No. Only maybe individual person from parliament member, not to be party attention. Because the party the top managerial top politician is only talk about the politic only talk about the share and election.
So how about the trial process? Trial.
Yes.
Criminal trial.
Yeah. What kind? Now
in your observation, in your cases, are you happy with the process?
Yes. Sometimes in every single cases we are fighting with the police. We are using all kind of method to advocating the cases. For example, when the student arrest by police in demonstration, we can menemui apa ya menemui ya kami bisa menemui.
We cannot meet. Yo, kau bisa menemui. We can meet.
We can meet in the fifth day, in the fourth or fifth day. So in 3 days, arresting by police, they don't have a lawyer, and we.
So even the lawyer is not allowed to see a client.
Yes.
For the first 5 days.
Yes. This situation is bad situation in Indonesia. Why? Because the police. Trying to erasing the injury in their body. Use all method to erasing the torture what impact in this in their body. With the warm water process like that.
So as the Bar Association ask that the lawyer should be able to meet the clients immediately.
We have a problem with the Bar Association. We don't have single Bar Association. We have a multi Bar Association, and the Bar Association tidak melakukan tugasnya untuk mengontrol dan menjadi sebuah kontrol publik.
So the Bar Association doesn't work as public control or external oversight.
Yeah, lawyer in Indonesia rarely in average talk about the business, talk about the money, not talk about the depend on human right. The problem with Bar Association Indonesia, for example, we have it Pradi in one name Pradi. The biggest Bar Association in Indonesia, and since 2015 we have three Pradi in the same name. Pradi one name but three organization in same name, three chairman. Yes, Bar Association not to be as a control, public control, and depend the association right. So we also came to the office of Bar Association, and they are helping us to discuss that like that. So, but like they are alienating with their problem on their problem.
So how do you see any change being brought about? What is your organization? How do you see in the future some changes being brought about? Is it possible or it is not possible at all?
Yeah, it's possible, but it's hard hard way for us, for Indonesia. Even in now, we call it the police Indonesia now is have a very very strong relation, strong position in the politics now, because the police helping the president in the presidential election. Informal, yeah, informal. The national commander of police very very helping the president to win the election with their apa ya apa istilahnya itu
network
dengan kekuatan mereka dengan support mereka
with their power and supporting system.
Supporting system, yes. Also in the parliament member, parliament member cannot give apa ya pengawasan ya. Cannot give
oversight
to the police body. We don't hear any big protest from parliament member to police when they are meeting in the office of parliament.
So if you have to make a complaint about bad conduct on the part of any police officer, is there a mechanism, is there a way to do that?
Yeah, they have a mechanism,
but does it like work?
We call it a propam, internal mechanism, but yeah, sometimes some cases it's effective, but a lot of cases not effective.
So it's only an internal mechanism.
Internal mechanism from from propam. Also, we use it the external mechanism. Sometimes we are using the media to speak up to helping us. For example, in this month, we trying to speak up with Mata Najwa. Mata Najwa is one of famous television show in Indonesia. So we bring the victim torture from police. We bring the victim the activist NGO who's have a police brutality to speak up in this show, Mata Najwa show. Also, we are sometimes using the international mechanism. We are reporting to the special procedure or special rapporteur. But in Jokowi era is a bad situation when Jokowi doesn't have any, he don't care about the international relation. Since situation in 14, Jokowi tidak pernah berkunjung dan memberikan sambutan di forum-forum HAM.
So in the time of Mr. President Jokowi, he almost never attend the International Forum on Human Rights.
Yes. In UN, not
in the UN, in the UN United Nations.
Yeah, it's very different with the Susilo Bambang Yudhoyono era. Susilo Bambang Yudhoyono era, yeah. So give attention. He came also to the Forum of Human Rights. Jokowi never came.
Has there been recommendations from the UN to the government about this situation, about torture and things like that in Indonesia?
Yeah, we have several recommendations. In some cases, to Indonesian government, for example, maybe Chris know about the Budi Pego cases in East Java.
Yes, we know. We have published through HRC.
Yeah, for example, for Budi Pego, a lot of international organization, also from EHRC, giving the recommendation to Indonesian government, also from special rapporteur. From UN body, So the government is don't care about this this letter, mm-hmm. and Budi Pego charged with the criminalized with the issuing of communism political party.
How do you see the situation of the human rights defenders, other than lawyers?
Yeah, it's also danger for our human rights defender in Indonesia. For example, our lawyer, woman lawyer, Era Purnamasari, in the last year, depending the customary people in Jambi province, 50 farmers in Jambi, they are fighting with the corporation, Sinarmas Corporation, and they are tortured and arresting by police. Era trying to defend their right in the court, and Era and Era was intimidated by police in Jambi. Police using the premana bahasanya,
stuck or
paramilitary or vigilante, yeah. to intimidate Era in the court. They are came to the court and trying to find Era, and we are evacuate Era from the court.
So the how is the situation of the National Human Rights Commission? Can they play a role to get some of these changes in the law?
Yeah, Indonesia National Human Rights Commission was also helping us to speak up, and also in every week they are receiving our report, and sometimes we are in emergency situation, we are direct contact with WhatsApp or maybe by phone to helping us in a lot of situation. The police and also our country don't giving any big respect to National Human Rights Commission. They are only speak and only trying, maybe like an NGO in Indonesia. For example, when National Human Rights Commission Indonesia speak up about the Omnibus Law Bill, and they are suggest to stop the process in DPR in parliament. Yesterday, when the parliament membahas bahasanya discuss about the budget, because budgeting in Indonesia is about ini merupakan bagian dari hak DPR membahas gitu.
So discuss about the state budget is part of the parliament's authority.
Yes, when the National Human Rights Commission invite by parliament, the parliament member is angry and have a bad comment to the National Human Rights Commission. Why you speak about the draft of bill? Two of parliament member Arteria and Sumariono speak. Don't speak again with our duty.
How does this affect the freedom of expression in the country?
Very bad impacting. So we had a release. Maybe a lot of publish. It's a kind of tanda-tanda symbol of authoritarianism era. It's a back of a comeback authoritarianism era. It's same with the Suharto era. So, for example, Freedom House downgrading Indonesia situation from free to partly free. In 2018, I think. Yeah. Yeah, Prisha.
Can you explain that a little?
Yeah, Freedom House before, if since 2003 until 2015, giving the Indonesia as a free state free in the Freedom House indicator. But since 2014, Indonesia down to partly free situation, because the, for example, for in freedom of expression, we found a lot of violation, lot of bad situation. But not only in cases, also with the news law, for example, internet and transaction electronic law, it's to be article make criminalization lot of activists. For example, for Jering, is charged with the ITA law.
Regarding the freedom of association for trade unions and things like that.
Yeah. Also, it's same situation.
So would you say that
in 2017, the presidential have a presidential decree. Apa ya, perpu bahasanya, decree ya. Presidential decree change the, we call it ormas law. Apa ormas bahasa Inggrisnya, please? Organization mass of law.
Yeah, mass organization.
Mass organization. Yeah, the law changed by presidential decree, and then bring up to the parliament member, but the news law is the government can apa membubarkan?
Can disperse, possibly disperse.
Yeah, can disperse, possibly disperse without the trial, without the court decision. The government used it with HPI, Hizbut Tahrir Indonesia.
So can we say that by and large the public space is shrinking?
Yes. We're facing the public space shrinking. And a lot of research has speak about this situation.
So is there
for example, Lokataru Foundation, you know, Haris Azhar. Haris Azhar also has established about the shrinking the public area, Lokataru Foundation, terus Robertus Robert. YHBHI, Freedom House, Amnesty International, Human Rights Watch was talk about this situation, shrinking space.
So is there a common understanding among all your human rights groups about the situation? So is there some kind of a front developing to these things jointly?
For example, in pandemic era, almost every week we are joint release in press release together with the human rights organization, lot of human organization in one release to protest to the government about the their lack of capacity, their bad way to facing this situation. Can you imagine in this situation, in this pandemic, the government will be emergency law, will using emergency law, but we are all protest and the government canceling using the emergency law. So the impact is, yeah. Every week we are here from the lots of area in Sumatra, in Kalimantan, in Sulawesi, lots of activists, farmer, arresting by police when they are confronting the apa land grabbing like that, deforestation, and other cases.
You mentioned about land grabbing.
Yeah, land grabbing, deforestation is the one of the biggest problem in agraria problem in Indonesia. Because the government, because the government giving the red carpet from for the investor, and investor come to the customarily land, to the farmer land, and they are land grabbing the land from farmer, and farmer or customarily people fight this situation, and in this situation the corporation using the military and the police to facing the people. For example, in this month in Kinipan, one of apa ketua adat istilahnya,
the head of local tribe,
yeah, local arresting by police because this local tribe rejecting the corporation to use this land, and the government giving the permit formal permit to the corporation to using this land, using their land in Kalimantan, in central of Kalimantan.
This is happening all over the Indonesia or in some parts. Land grabbing?
Yeah, really. More danger in Papua, in eastern of Indonesia, in Sulawesi, in Kalimantan, in Papua, the foreign journalist is prohibit to do walking in Papua. So the foreign journalist cannot come to Papua and working in Papua, no.
From when is that?
What?
When did that start?
Dari kapan itu?
Maybe 2015. And also the biggest problem now, Basil, is intimidating or violation by digital security. So lots of activists, lot of journalists, also the for example Tempo hack, Raffio Patra hack, we don't know, but we are kami curiga apa ya,
we are suspicious,
yeah, we again. Are suspicious, it's from yeah, intelligence institution. It's a lot of cases, very very danger. And also after that, the journalist or activist doxing by buzzer or by
anybody has been arrested for using the internet media.
Yeah, after we are reporting to the police. And we don't have any good progress from police. Tempo Tirto was reporting to the police this kind of violation from digital security, and until now the police we don't hear any progress.
Has any journalist being arrested for putting things in the using the social media?
Yeah. For example, the last month, Diananta, journalist from Kumparan, he is writing in his media, Banjar Hits in Kalimantan land, Kalimantan, Borneo land, and is arresting and was diten apa diputus bersalah apa ya,
punished by the judge,
for 2 years,
or sentenced by the judge for 2 years, three years ya,
itu apa saya lupa 3 tahun ya, tapi
3 years into jail or suspended sentence,
yeah, in jail, Diananta. You can searching in googling in Google Diananta journalist from Kalimantan.
So your organization is working
because he is speak up about the corruption.
So corruption is not allowed to be talked about in the media.
No. It's apa ya istilahnya ya? Istilahnya itu intervensi. It's intervention by the corruptor to the police staff. When the corruptor don't receive their his writing, his niche, his news, and corruptor intervention to the police to arresting them with the charge of blasphemy, not blasphemy, defamation, with the
criminal defamation article.
So your organization is working under very difficult circumstances.
Yeah. For example, me and Aswin. Aswin also was reporting the police.
So, Mr. Basil, 3 or 4 years ago, his office also surrounded by paramilitary thugs and mass organization because they announced to the public that Indonesian Legal Aid is pro-communism because they give space for victims of 1965 massacre to have discussion and also photo exhibition in Mr. Isnur's office. So Mr. Isnur maybe can explain that case as well.
Yeah, we are accompanying a lot of victims from 1965 massacres, and in 2017, I think, 2018, we are have a discuss about the history with the academician, with the researcher in our building. And the police prohibit us to continuing the discuss, and we are canceling the discuss. And in the night, we are discuss and singing about this situation in Indonesia, bad situation in Indonesia, and thousand paramilitary come to our office and intimidate and also throwing the stone to our building, and also intimidating all people in the building in the run all night in one night, and after that we are close our office in 1 week.
Okay, we covered quite a lot of issues, so maybe on a each occasion, we can try to deal with them in a little more detail, each of the issues. Police issue, the land grabbing issue, the shrinking of public space. We can do it in a little detail.
Yeah.
So for today, I think we covered quite a lot. So thank you very much.